So the Lahontan cutthroat trout is one of the native species to the eastern Sierras, principally the Truckee, Walker, and Carson watersheds. Historically here in California, the Lahontan cutthroat trout was both economically and recreationally important. Over the last 100 years or so, the populations have diminished to the point that now the species is federally listed as threatened. In California, we're working with many partners to bring this species back and reintroduce them into the historic watershed where they'll be available for angling and other recreational uses. We are supporting both the recreational aspect of Lahontan cutthroat trout fisheries as well as the conservation aspect of the Lahontan cutthroat trout fishery. Through our efforts to conserve this species, we're sending scientists out regularly to check on known populations to determine the health and the size of the populations and if there are any means for us to enhance or grow those populations. Then of course we have our recreational fisheries, which we're using our hatchery raised fish to help support, as well as wild fish, to allow anglers to have that opportunity to catch an iconic sport fish. We raise them up to multiple size classes, which range from everywhere from fingerling to sub-catchable to just under catchable size, which are about 10 inches or under, and then release them onto the landscape. On top of those, we also release independent strain trophy Lahontan cutthroat trout into many waters of the Carson and Truckee watershed. To California anglers, the Lahontan cutthroat trout can mean a fantastic opportunity to be able to get your hands on an iconic sport fish of the American West. On top of that, the Lahontan cutthroat trout can also grow to immense sizes in the proper conditions. We can end up with fish that average 18 inches or greater, and it's not uncommon to get fish in the 6 to 8 pound range. So one of the beauties about the Lahontan cutthroat trout, and I know this because I'm an angler myself, is the ease in which you can catch them. It tends to occupy the near shore habitat, making it susceptible to angling from shore. So you don't necessarily need boats with downriggers, though they can help seasonally. You can be very successful just from the shore using a variety of gear, from baits to lures to even fly fishing. Your best seasons are going to be in the early summer, late spring after ice out, or then in the late fall as the water temperatures start to get colder. Those fish are going to be looking to put on as much weight before the winter comes around. The summertime, you can still catch them, but they're going to be, your techniques are going to have to change a little bit. Earlier in the season, those fish are going to be kind of up, shallower, feeding a little more aggressively. In the summertime, that bite is going to slow down a little bit. You want to change your tactics over, maybe to using bait, maybe a little more passive techniques to catch them, but you can still definitely do it. The time of day is really important. You're early in the morning and you're late in the evening, just like with many trout and char species, are going to be your optimum times to fish. This is also when the forage food is going to be most active. So that's when the fish are going to be looking for that prey item most. In the evenings, you get a large hatch of invertebrates that are coming off that those fish are going to be keyed in on. Other species of native minnows like the Lahontan redside and speckled dace are going to be keying in on those invertebrates. Those bigger trout are going to be keying in on those bait fish. And if you're tossing lures or flies that mimic that food source, you're going to do pretty good.